Welcome, everybody, to the final of the men's gymnastics at the World Championships in Antwerp. Hugely important competition, the qualifying competition for the Olympic Games next year in Paris. And Craig and I are eagerly anticipating.
We certainly are. 2 days of qualification so far. First up was the men's qualification, and we had the women's yesterday. And this is the team to beat. Japan qualified in first place. Quite a solid qualification, Christine.
Yes, they were indeed. A little bit clear of the rest of the field. Four marks.
And the second team out, qualified really well, second place, Team USA. Be interesting to see if they can replicate qualification. They've been a bit, I'm going to say, inconsistent in previous championships, so ones to watch for certain.
Yes, they often have qualified well and then faded in the final, but I'm sure they look up for it today, Craig.
Certainly do, and it's interesting, we'll see some new faces and with less than a year to go to the Olympic Games, I think a lot of the stronger nations will be testing some of these young gymnasts to see if they can fit into that lineup. This is Switzerland. They qualified down in seventh place.
Just the top eight countries here in the final. There was a qualifying competition 2 days ago, a whole day and a half of it, and just the top eight nations go on to this team final.
And actually qualified in the bottom spot for the team final. China was a real surprise. They've had a bit of injury. They've flown in Lin Xiaopan, straight from the Asian Games. They're the defending world champions, so expect them to catapult up the scoreboard, Chris.
Yep, they'll certainly be fighting to retain their title. Scores start from scratch. Doesn't matter where you qualified, today is a new competition.
And the boys from Great Britain out into the arena. Good, solid qualification in third place. Just slightly behind Team USA, but certainly room for opportunity there, Christine.
Yes, they were in the very first round in the qualifying competition. It was early morning, and they made a couple of uncharacteristic mistakes. So I'm sure they'll put them right today and be chasing down the leaders.
Certainly will, and having somebody like Max on the team, fresh from winning the World Cup in Paris, put in a huge scoring qualification on the pommel horse. So that will certainly give the lads lots of confidence. But what a team this has been, Canada. They've qualified in fourth place for this team final. Absolutely phenomenal where you think they've come from over the last sort of two gymnastic cycles.
Yes, they haven't qualified a full team for the Olympics for quite a while, but they did that 2 days ago, so they're on an absolute high.
On still rings, Team Germany.
Next out is the lads from Germany, qualified for this final in fifth. Again, some older gymnasts in that team and some new guys. So they'll be wanting to keep in the mix of things.
With Pascal Brendel, Lukas Dauser, Nils Dunkel, Nick.
So the teams will be split, working around the apparatus. And there'll be one from one nation up and then the one from the next. Three gymnasts up, all three scores to count, so it's full of jeopardy, Chris.
It is indeed. And we see Italy come into the arena here. Very strong team over this cycle. From since the last Olympics, they've been very strong, very powerful. Didn't qualify quite as high as they have in the past. Sixth position in qualification for this.
Well, they were fourth in the last World Championships, and they seem to be significantly better in the recent Europeans. So again, Maybe trying a few new team members out, getting the formation right for the Olympics. There's a lot more behind the scenes that goes on about putting your best team out. So Germany will start on rings with Italy. Great Britain onto the pommel. So a little bit of a shaky piece to start on, Chris. We were just talking about that to Gianni then. If you want to settle the nerves, rings and vault's quite a good one. Pommels, you've got to be. It's almost like the equivalent to starting on the women's beam.
Yes, it's great if you have a good session because it's behind you and you're very happy. But it's the great precision apparatus of the men's program, pommel horse. Everything has to be so precise. You only need to be a centimetre out and you've fallen off the apparatus. So the top two teams in qualification start on the floor area. And that's really quite a nice piece of apparatus to get yourself going on. It wakes your legs up, and here you can see that the gymnasts are going to alternate. You've got one from Japan, one from USA, one from Japan, one from USA, and so on. So I quite like this format, don't you, Craig? So you've got a direct comparison between the two nations.
Absolutely, and it's almost man for man going round. I think it really adds to the excitement of the competition. Definitely. And believe it or not, Great Britain were the highest scoring nation in qualification. And a lot of it has to do with that young man. Yeah, Max Whitlock posted the highest score, 15.266. And it's a real team effort to adjust the handles. Such an accomplished gymnast now. Each gymnast has 30 seconds or one touch on the apparatus. Generally, the gymnast won't compete the full or warm up the full routine. It'll just be a few elements.
Just to get used to the arena. They've come from the back gym. They've been warming up in another gym adjacent to this one. But it won't be under the bright lights and everything. So this little warm up is a good position for them to acclimatise themselves. Each team puts up their three best gymnasts on each apparatus. So you've got a pool of five gymnasts, a team of five gymnasts, and you choose your best three on each piece. And you'll see, actually, there'll be some that are quite specialists on some apparatus, like rings, and others who are more all-round gymnasts.
Yeah. There you can see China on vault with Switzerland. Interesting that China had the 18th highest score for the vault. So I think that's where they struggled in the qualification, but no doubt they will be a force to reckon with. And again, it's as you said, Christine, it doesn't matter what you've done in qualification, it all starts from zero now. And sometimes it's always good to have a little bit of a shaky qualification. As long as you qualify for the finals and the apparatus finals and the all-round, it just settles the nerves and you can make those small adjustments for the final.
Absolutely. So there were several things riding on the qualification competitions. Qualification for this, the opportunity to compete to be world champions. But also the top 12 countries qualified for the Olympic Games. So it's been a very nerve-wracking few days for all the teams here, but we know now who are the people we're going to see at the Olympic Games in Paris.
A real nice view of the arena there. So first up, for Japan on the floor. He actually topped the all-round competition. He's Kenta Chiba to get this World Championships team final underway.
Tremendous responsibility. Lovely double pike front somersault. Another, and he saved that well, but he will lose a few marks for that little scurry backwards. Very nice combination, finishing with a 2.5 twisting front. We'd seen all back forward somersaults, that was backward. You have to do a variety of somersaults in your routine, and you also have to show balance and non-tumbling elements. Just a little brush of the toes as he lifted to handstand for the beautiful, secure handstand shape. Big concentration for another big tumble. Oh, 2.5 twist, and he killed the front somersault afterwards. He got his feet down, but it was very low. Lovely triple twist, but I think there were a couple of errors there that will keep that score, first score for Japan, down a bit, Craig.
Yeah, a bit of a shaky start there for Japan. Some big tumbles. Big twisting. Obviously very spatially aware.
First gymnast for Great Britain, James Hall, on the pommel horse.
Nicely controlled up into the handstand. Gymnasts have got to show some single leg work. That's a very difficult skill on the one handle. He's got to really drive the heels to keep the momentum. That's it, good work, James. Skills on the one handle. To build the difficulty, traveling backwards, that's a Gibardo travel. And going forward, come on, James. Oh, well, what a shame. Just that little bit of a leg separation and the shoulders go slightly to one side. And you're off, one full mark. 30 seconds to compose. Come on, James. Got to pick himself back up. That's better. Up into the handstand pirouette. Well, what a shame for James Hall. It's not what you want. First person really needs to settle the team. Really unfortunate, Chris.
Yes, very unfortunate. It was really quite well into the routine, nearly at the end, and he'll be very disappointed with that. But that's not a great huge score for Japan either, 12.933. Just shows how easily the nerves can get to these gymnasts.
Let's see what USA can do on the floor. First up for them. The Yul Mandar.
Probably the most experienced member of the USA team. And that was a super high, 2.5 twisting forwards. Double into full. It's all about these really secure landings. Any step or hesitation on landing, and there's a deduction. Well, we've seen three big tumbles there and three great landings. Lovely speed and leg separation on the flares. Oh, a little bit of originality as well. This is a pacey routine. Works with fluency. Relatively simple side pass, double twist. Lovely flight on the straight front somersault at the end of that series. Has he got one more great landing in him? He has, triple twist. That was a very good start for USA.
Superb opening routine. Lots of difficulty, but what stood out for me was the precision on the landings. Interesting, the half in, half out. A bit of a nervous wait in the GB camp. 11.933 for James Hall.
So all the three scores have to count. Zach Clay for Canada, one of the most improved teams here.
Canada will be flying a bit of a high in their qualification. He's got a good extension on this double leg circle. Look at the hips over the top of the pommel horse. He's got a lovely rhythm and tempo. And this is the thing with this piece of apparatus. It's the speed, it helps you balance. Well done, come on. Working well. The forward travel, Maggie Orr, and backwards, Chivado. Listen out for those skills. Up into the handstand. Solid routine. Great work for Canada.
Well, he's certainly done his job for the team. Lovely style. Big smile at the finish.
Well known internationally, but in Japan, his claim to fame is that in 2017, he won the
first for Switzerland. Up onto the vault.
And a good, well-flighted two-and-a-half twist. He flipped onto the table, round off in front of the platform.
Good vaulting for Florian Legenega. 14.233. Ooh, just 0.1 there for going outside the lines.
See the team members sitting, cheering their team on. There's the score for Yul Mulder, 14.366. That's a good, solid start.
Just watched the third man on board for Switzerland. That was the first look at Italy. Onto the rings, Yumin Aberdini. 13.5 in qualification.
And Italy, a country with a great pedigree on the rings. You have to hold these strength elements for 3 seconds. He's shown that beautifully there. You have to swing to the handstands on straight arms, both forwards and backwards, so he's fulfilled those requirements. Very nice style, legs locked together, 2 double somersaults linked. Takes massive strength, it goes without saying. Great control through the middle of the body and through the hands. Here comes the big dismount, double-double. Well, there weren't many deductions there, Craig.
No, good, solid start. What with some of the difficulty we will see in this competition, great dismount, 2 somersaults, 2 twists, plenty of height and flight. Zachary Clay, 14.2, great opening score for Canada on pommels. It's a long way around this competition, Chris. And this is where you need the experience just to settle the nerves, pick yourself up from the mistakes.
It is indeed. 6 pieces of apparatus the gymnasts do. And this is a very exciting young gymnast. Fred Richard from USA posted some very big scores in qualification. Frederick Richard, USA.
Oh, huge opening tumble, 2 twists, 2.5 twists, sorry, 2 somersaults. Lovely control, double twist into a straight front with a full twist. Second highest score in qualification on this piece of apparatus. Lovely air flare, showing great originality. Lovely control. easy as you like. Double twisting, double back. Easily round the double twist. Really light gymnast, seems to float across the floor. Lovely control again, spatially aware. This is a great routine. Hold it together. Full twisting double back. USA are flying tonight, Chris.
They certainly look like they are. They love a big arena. These American gymnasts, they often compete in big arenas like that, and that was a super opening tumble. 2.5 twists, double somersault.
Great to have him here. So, Germany onto the rings. Nils Dunkel.
Swing to strength there, and again, link strength elements gives you bonus marks. Another one, the shoulders have to be down in line with the hands. That was great. Here come the swinging elements, the swing to handstand. And into the double front somersault. He's building his difficulty with all these moves. Super straight arms on the lift to handstand. There's the forward swing to handstand. Needs a good, clean finish. It is just a little stutter on the landing, little 0.3 deduction for that, but a very nicely flighted double straight with full twist.
There you can see the elements. 13.7. Nils Dunkel of Germany. Showing some nice ring work. Just lacking a little bit on the difficulty. Really got to have some strength to get into the 14s. Aberdeeni, 13.266.
Oh, and this, the man of the moment. That's Whitlock. Qualification performed brilliantly on the pommel horse. His team certainly need that from him right now. Max Whitlock to the pommel horse.
We hold our breaths. Good, solid start. Lovely control in the handstand. On the one handle, that is huge difficulty. Down between the handles, the Wendy swing. Back up onto the handles, it's full of original work, full of difficulty. The Stockley's up into the handstand, he'll come back down into the flare. Superb control, such a difficult skill. This is good work, come on. The woo travel back down the horse, into the woo on the end. This is great work, just a dismount to go. Up into the handstand, pirouette. Whitlock wonders again, fantastic. Just what we needed.
Fantastic, Max, he looks really very stylish to me here. Quite a lot of the elements he's worked hard on in his rest period and are looking so well executed.
Sensational, onto the floor. Kazuki Minami, to improve Japan's performance.
Two and a half twisting double back into a front summary with full twist. Absolutely unbelievable. Oh, super height, super twisting. Lovely style. See the extension through the legs. Strong in that handstand, lovely straight shape. Handstand wants to be straight from fingers to toes. Oh, and very complex twisting there. He really can build his difficulty by putting big, difficult elements together in one tumble. Here just finishes with the triple twist. Now that, for me, is the best final triple that I've seen today in competition.
Yes, Chris, and to be honest, that's the first time I've ever seen that opening tumble done. Two and a half twisting, double back, immediately punched out. I mean, this is just the such difficult work. Look, two and a half, immediately, straight front, full twist.
Actually quite unbelievable, isn't
unbelievable it? Because he's got to fit it in the floor as well. Most people struggle to get that across the diagonal. I think Max will get near 15. He has 15.266, and not too much damage for Great Britain there. Well done.
Massive 6.9 in difficulty. Wow.
Actually, Chris, that's the same score as he scored in qualification.
Very consistent. Canada and GB, of course, on the same apparatus, two teams on each piece. So, ready, Konoya for Canada.
He only scored 12.933 in qualification. So obviously a little error, but that's a good solid start. Quite a stocky gymnast. And this is a really difficult piece of apparatus if you carry a lot of muscle mass. If you look at the frame of René compared to Max, he's taking a lot of double leg circles. And the problem is, when you've got such a muscular frame, the lactic acid kicks in. And that's what happens, Chris. From the apparatus. He didn't look happy from the start. Back to the apparatus. Come on. Up into the handstand, pirouette, no problem. Be a costly mistake. René Konoye of Canada.
And as we've said, every score has to count. There's no dropping a score today.
Richard, Frederick Richard, 14.366. I like this gymnast, Chris.
Yeah, a little bit down on his qualification, I think. If we look, yes, he was a little bit higher in qualification. But they've got great energy, this team from USA, haven't they?
They certainly have. Yeah. I mean, they have been noted over the years for being a very flamboyant team.
And this is opportunity for Canada if they
so
can do what they
vault,
did in the qualification.
And China didn't have a happy outing on vaulting qualification, but that is much better. Such a beautiful triple twist off the top of that platform.
Yeah, when it goes right, it's textbook. And this is a lesson in twisting. Look at that. 14.866, execution 9.266. Execution goes from 10, and then you've got your difficulty score. Be interesting to see what the rest of the Chinese team have done on vault. It's very hard to get a picture of the standings. And this is going to be the other gymnast from China, Su Wade.
And another very solid vault. They're absolutely highly delighted. They came in eighth position. So bottom of the pile. They won't be after this vault rotation.
Definitely not. Again, the gymnast needs to create such speed and rotation. 14.7, a 9-1 in execution. Look at that, 43.299 for the vault.
The vault, of course, is one of the highest scoring pieces, but I think they're probably, after this first apparatus, going to be in the lead.
Well, they had a 41.996, so a big improvement.
So we come to the rings. Lorenzo Casali for Italy. He's one of their renowned rings workers.
Yeah, another. They're quietly consistent, this Italian team, on this piece of apparatus. Mid 13s. Tend to get a lot of their difficulty from the swinging elements. Circle round into the crucifix. Gymnasts on all these strength elements have to hit the correct position for at least 2 seconds. Lovely double front swinging, double pike, the back up rise into the straddle lever. Just a little bit soft in the knees there. Got to keep the elbows, shoulders off the ring wires. Backward long swing, one of the requirements. Four requirements on each apparatus. You see a little bit of a flex in his right elbow. So that's a 10th. Double twisting, double back. It was through, solid routine. Probably mid-13s, I reckon.
Yes, he's good and stylish. Lovely height on the somersaults. And there's the score. You were right, Craig. Mid-13s, 13.5. Putting them in sixth place after the first apparatus.
It's quite a difficult piece of apparatus to get a good score on through swinging elements.
We get another little chance here to watch this amazing first tumble.
For me, this is the combination of the championships so far. I mean, it's only round one, but to see something you've never seen before is something pretty special.
And like you say, you know, he had to take a fair run into the first part of that tumble. So 14.433 for Minami Kazuki. That wraps up this first round. Remember, six pieces of apparatus, so there's plenty of opportunity for teams to fight back and equally for teams to fall about.
Well, we've seen two out of the three floor routines from Team USA that look phenomenal. So again, it's down to that third person. Bit of a mishap for GB on the pommel horse with James Hall. We haven't seen what Jake Jarman did, but Max put in a superb routine. Rene Kanoya, again, 11.033. Look at the difficulty, Christine, 4.2. You can tell with his shoulders, it's a difficult piece of apparatus for him to work.
So both the teams that started on pommel horse had at least one fall.
It's it's a men's equivalent to the women's beam, I think.
Yeah, very tricky.
And the thing is, the more double leg circles you do, the more tired you get in your arms, and as soon as that lactic acid gets in, it's pretty tough to fight on through.
So the gymnasts are moving round now to their next apparatus. They'll have their warm-up, 30 seconds each. So six people on each piece of apparatus, that's a 3-minute warm-up. So it's not too lengthy. But USA certainly look up for it, Craig.
They do. It's just whether they can keep the consistency. Five more apparatus. And I think what the British team are really good at is they come back from these little setbacks early on and really do pull together. Might just get some standings with a bit of luck.
With just four pieces of apparatus being used at any one time, we've got eight teams in. So they move on now, one apparatus. So the piece we haven't seen, but we'll get a chance to now, is parallel bars. You can see USA have moved to pommel horse. Very different to the floor.
Absolutely, and that's the challenge of gymnastics. It really does test the all-around athlete. You've got to be strong, you've got to be flexible, you've got to be agile, you've got to be springy. Great Britain go to rings, along with Canada. Germany and Italy go to vault. We've just seen China and Switzerland are on parallel bars, and Japan, which I'm not sure, Christine, after the floor routine scores from Japan, whether they're leading this competition so far. They're not for showing us the scores anyhow, are they?
No, I was going to say, we haven't had a show. I've got some scores up here, but I think it's without the final USA floor score, which is probably why we're not being shown it at the moment. There's judges deciding on the D score, the difficulty, and there's other judges decided on execution, and they all have to agree before a score will be published. So I think we're not getting the scores, Craig, because I don't think that final USA floor score is in, actually.
Yeah, I can just say that, Chris. 43.299 for China, Switzerland 42.99, Japan 41.666, and then Great Britain with 40.432. So about three marks down from qualification on pommels. So I'm not sure what happened to Jake Jarman. Anyhow, they've got to pick themselves up and concentrate on the rest of the competition.
So here we go with it. China are top at the moment after that great vault rotation. United States up in second, Switzerland third. They were also on vault. Vault is very often the highest scoring piece. So until everyone's done the vault, you haven't got a true picture of how it's going to be.
And can I remind you, Christine, at the last World Championships, Great Britain were in eighth place at one point in the competition and clawed the way back to that bronze medal. So it is possible.
It certainly is. So these are the teams on vault this time round, Italy and Germany. Waiting in anticipation, and here's the pommel hall, the P-bars that we haven't seen before. And actually, this is a piece that China are usually very, very strong on.
Yeah.
The top two teams, Japan and USA, have moved off to pommel horse. And we see the first performer for USA, Yul Moldar, on the pommel horse.
Just a little bit of strength there up into the handstand. But again, quite a fast tempo. He was zippy on the floor. And he is on this piece of apparatus. Again, the faster the circle. Keeps the balance, separates the legs there in the flares. Lovely work. Travelling down the horse. This in the past has been a bit of an Achilles heel for the American team, but actually, big improvement. Oh, he did well.
He
good
did.
Stop. He saved it on the dismount.
He did very well. You could almost see his concentration. You could see his concentration slip away when he'd got to the point of going up to the dismount. You have to keep focus to the very, very end. He fought it back well, but it will have accrued a few deductions for him.
Well, interesting, China. We'll see Lin Xiaopan, who's been pulled in as a reserve. A second up. So first up for China on the parallel bars, Sun Wei.
And all the Chinese are impressive on parallel bars, but this gymnast so impressive. Look at that fantastic straight handstand shape. Lovely double back between the rails. You see his absolute straight line from toes to fingers. And when he does his double pike somersault, his legs are locked together so tight. He's such a classy gymnast. Lovely high front somersault. Complete control on the pirouette. Flies through the air and catches those rails. Really lovely parallel bar work. You have to be able to control the handstand, swing. Another great handstand, and then he must give a well-landed dismount. There's the full pirouette. All these moves add towards the difficulty. The most difficult 10 elements go together to count. Here it comes, double front with half turn. I don't think you'll see much better P-bar work than that, do you, Craig?
Superb, absolutely superb. From China on parallel bars, just what they needed. This is a real piece of apparatus that the Chinese gymnasts have dominated for many years. Everything is just performed to perfection. Beautiful straight lines in the handstand. Lots of virtuosity, originality. And there's a deviation down the back. The skill over the top of the bars, the Bavzar skill.
And so to the vault, Italy, Mario Marchietti. 5-2 in difficulty, this vault.
Oh, lovely wraps in for the 2.5 twist. Very clean, actually, that, Chris. Straight down the middle. So the most the gymnast can score is 15.2.
So Yul Mulder, 13.533. It was a good routine, but 5-9 in difficulty, one whole mark less than Max Whitlock.
Interesting, Chris, though. It was a mark up from qualification.
Japan.
So Kazuma Kaya moves to the pommel horse for Japan.
Has the potential to get up into the 14s, but he won't if he carries on like that. That flex in the arms. That's better, good control. This is nice work now. He's settled into the routine. Good clearance between the hips as he breaks into the flares. Side travel. Lovely height above the pommel horse there, the Woo. Forward travel on the Magyar. Backwards Shabado. Little hand shuffle there into the Proact. Good routine. I think he's slightly pleased with that, Chris. Go on, son.
True warrior.
So, Lukas Kotchen of Volt from Germany.
Also a 5-2. The turn on, the 2.5 twist off. Just a little hop to the side, but in the air, his flight was so beautifully extended.
I thought he was going to actually nail that, Christine.
Yeah, I did as well. He's so tidy and tight, isn't he?
Look at that, legs locked together. Oh, and just that little, that'll be a point one. 1 foot outsider on the line. But lovely vaulting.
So Sungwei, 14.73361. They had a few marks off him, only 8.6 in execution. But that's an impressive opening score for China.
It is, and another one that's improved from qualification, half a mark better. Jetty, 14.333 with the 0.1 penalty.
Packed arena here. Kazuma Kaya, 14.2 on the pommel horse. 6-3, a good difficulty score there. And the gymnasts from the USA were so explosive on the floor. Can they harness the control needed on this pommel horse? Go Fred, they're shouting. Frederick Richard for the USA on the pommel horse.
A little bit of strength at the start to get to that first handstand. Lovely rhythm and tempo between the handles. Oh, and that's good separation in the legs on the flares. The spindle, the turns within the flare position. Great work. Forward travel, Magyar, and backwards with the Shabado. This is looking good. Can he hold on for the handstand dismount? It can! Well, in the past, this piece of apparatus has been a bit of an Achilles heel for Team USA, but these guys doing a great job.
Well, he was so fast and whipped through that routine. His circles were sometimes a little bit close to the handles, which will no doubt have the eagle-eyed judges deducting, but it was such a pacey routine. Lukas Kotchen, 14.366, also a 0.1. He just clipped the line with his foot when he hopped.
Interesting, now Frederick Richard there was opting for the flares. As you pointed out, Christine, his double leg circles aren't that good, and he's obviously really cleverly constructed that routine to utilise the flares. And that was a great routine.
Well, this guy looks as though he's built for the rings, doesn't he, Craig?
He certainly does. He struggled a bit on the pommel horse, but I expect an impressive performance on the rings with shoulders like that. Let's have a look at William Imar from Canada onto the rings.
Swings up to that wonderful strength position. Shoulders down in line with the rings. And again, top planche position, the body absolutely parallel to the floor. Oh, he just overcooked that handstand shape. He corrected it very well. And the second handstand, you have to show the locked shoulders and elbows. Super control. Then comes the swinging part. It's strength and swing these days on the rings. Fixes his body shape. Here comes that double twisting dismount, tiny hop to the side. Well, that was a very good routine for Canada. Wait for the judges. Just a little bit more chalk to keep the hands moving. For Switzerland, Christian Baumann onto the P bars.
This gymnast. Been around a while, 28 years of age. One of his favourite pieces of apparatus. Lovely transition there, the front somersault from the upper arm. That was lovely control there. Gymnasts have to perform skills above the rails and under, just like that, in the upper arm position, into the handstand. Changes the shape. Lovely skill there. The Bavs are. Could travel back into the middle of the bars. That deviation allows the body to glide through the rails. Swinging half turn. Lovely handstand shape. High into the double pike. Good solid routine. The Baumann of Switzerland.
Switzerland are a team renowned for good parallel bar work, but that ring score 13-8, that's a good score.
So, first look at this powerhouse for Great Britain. Courtney Tullock on the rings. So onto the rings for Great Britain's Courtney Tullock.
So often being the star of the show for Great Britain on rings. Would be wanting to be at his very best. Look at that fabulous shape. Heels as high as his shoulders. And again, holding it steadily. Here's his swinging elements. Locks out into that handstand, shows the control, and links to another great strength element. Very original move of his there. And a beautiful crucifix, shows his shoulders directly in line with his hands. Now he needs to nail here the handstand and then the big dismount. Every gymnast needs a big dismount. It has to add towards the difficulty. Double straight with full twist. Well done, Courtney. Feels good from that point of view.
Good routine for King Courtney. Just outside the rings final. I think that'll improve on qualification. Baumann, parallel bars, 14.133. Chris, you were right, it's a good routine. Good score.
It was indeed, but this one probably would hope to better it. So Yu Hao. Yu Hao on the parallel bars.
Well, another gymnast capable of getting up towards 15. For me, it's the way these gymnasts make this piece of apparatus look so effortless. Front up rise into the double back somersault. Again from the double pike back. The judges are looking that these skills have fully executed, open out before they catch the bars. Ah, oh, look at this, full of difficult work. Under somersault. Straight arms into the double pipe back. I mean, you just get to this piece of apparatus and you think they can't produce a better routine than the last, and they do. Lovely height and flat there in the tip out. Dismount to go, front up rise. Double front with a half turn. China are certainly in the game for this.
They certainly are. They came in bottom of the pile, and after one piece they were top. And I don't think they will be too far off after this showing either.
Well, it's nice to be able to call on a world champion, isn't it? From back in 2015, he's still got it.
Certainly has. Not bad to have in your locker.
Absolutely incredible. Oh, yeah, these Chinese team have certainly given themselves a good talking to between qualification and the final. But Nicola Bartolini next to go. A painted man on vault. A 5-2 difficulty, so going for execution.
And he is the king of execution. Absolutely. He is the most stylish gymnast in the men's field. And that was a perfect execution of a 2.5 twist off the top of the vault. Look, he turns on, blocks, up he goes, legs locked together, open the arms out to kill the landing. Great work.
14.566 for Bartolini. You're right there on the execution, Matt. 9.366 on execution.
Well, looking to move up from that seventh place after the first rotation. And Courtney Tullock's been awarded a 14.1. That puts Great Britain at the moment up into third, but still quite a bit of gymnastics left to go in this second rotation of six pieces. China leading 87.664, the team score 14.966. Everything's up. The execution's up. The difficulty's up. The team's up. Noah Seifert of Switzerland. He's the last gymnast to swing the parallel bars. He was in the European final earlier this year.
Well, just a little bit of loss of form in the back there. Not too costly though, the hand shuffle's only a 0.1. That was better, smooth transition, the front somersault. And that was a difficult skill, the turn from the one bar. Showing great control. It's always quite difficult to follow somebody on a piece of apparatus that performs a routine to the level that's just gone before. He's having a go, is this lad? Doing a great job. Double pike, just that little stumble on the dismount.
But that buoyancy of the Chinese is lifting, it really is lifting the Swiss. I mean, they were in third after the first piece of apparatus. It's exactly what you want from a team final, this. And three up, three to count. Every single deduction is costly.
Switzerland will be thrilled to be competing alongside these wonderful Chinese gymnasts, I think.
Well, Harry Hepworth, He's qualified in eighth place for the rings final. He scored 14.366. Known as a floor and vault specialist, so he's done incredibly well to get into the rings final.
Yep, 19 years old, came to work three pieces and topped the team on all those three pieces. And he's showing you that aggressive strength. Shoulders are in a wonderful position there. He's had a bit of a wait to get on here. But the shapes are good. The holds are strong. He's really being emphatic with those. And he's got big swing and energy. There we are, lovely height on that somersault. Straight up into the handstand. Absolutely locks it out. And another one. Now he's a tumbler, so he should be able to dismount. And he certainly can. Oh, big step on the landing. But double twisting, double tuck. Not happy with himself with that landing.
Well, apart from the dismount, guys, I really like that routine. He's hugely powerful.
Yeah, real shame on that dismount. Great Britain have dropped a few tenths on rings, and Harry did everything he could there. 14-1, the same as Courtney. 82.098. Great Britain were in fifth. Pascal Brendel of Germany. Just the one vault in the men's team final.
Beautiful handspring, double front. Very difficult vault to land. You don't see the floor before it arrives to you. You had to take a step back. He blocked really well. Block off, up into the 2.5 front somersaults. And he just was a little bit short, but 14-1.
They stay in sixth, same place as they were in after the first rotation. Across to Japan now, pommel horse. Daiki Hashimoto. Now, he had a bit of a nightmare on pommel horse in qualification. He brushed his leg and really lost his momentum. But all eyes are on him, the all-round king, world and Olympic all-round champion.
Yeah, and he does work this piece of apparatus well. That's lovely work, the flares, the spindles. Showing great control up into the handstand, back down into the double leg circle work. Good extension, hovers above the handles, that's what you're looking for. Splits again, the forward travel, Magyar in the flare and backwards in flares. Much better outing than qualification, just needs a good dismount, pirouettes round. Well, he's back. That was superb.
I tell you what, this is going all the way. They're pushing China here. Japan were in fourth after the first rotation, but they're on their way back, climbing.
Well, this is just beautiful work. He makes everything look so effortlessly easy. And it's anything but.
Fred Richard scores 12.5 on pommel horse. They drop down to fourth from second. Interested to see this pommel score, because Japan as a country actually won pommel horse. Noah Seifert scored 14.033 for his parallel bars. Switzerland move up at the moment, still scores to come in, but they'll be taking a photo of the scoreboard.
China are running away with it. Depends what Japan scored.
Now, Koi Young. Watch this young lad here. He's just 20 years old, but he's qualified second for the pommel horse final between Max and Reese.
Well, he's certainly got all the style, hasn't he? Really high above the pommel horse. But that looks to me like we are being shown the second half of a routine.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's not a Pommel final routine. It was very short, so he's obviously fallen off.
Wow, that is costly, costly for Team USA, because they will have been banking on his score. Yeah, 13.6 is way off what he scored in qualification.
Yes, he was a 15, I think, yeah. Matt, in qualification.
He was 15.066, so yeah, a costly fall for Team USA.
We did say that before the competition, though, about the Pommel horse being the Achilles heel, and actually, they were the second highest scoring team.
14.266 for Daiki Hashimoto in Japan. He scored 13.266 in qualification. So Japan going well in the flow.
So gymnasts move round now. Quick warm-up on the next piece.
I think we were seeing some highlights there of routines that were put in from earlier on.
See the British men in the background on vault. We've been in this position before, and I do still think this medal for Great Britain is a real possibility.
Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it, how many big deductions you can count as a team, because there's six pieces of apparatus, there's three gymnasts, every single routine counts. It's very, very difficult to go all the way around with every single gymnast, you know, without making a major deduction.
Yeah, I totally agree. And certainly out there, there'll be a bit of nerves for sure. It is a World Championships after all, and nobody just rocks into the World Championships with ease.
So there are the current standings, I'm guessing, after two now. So China leads Switzerland, with Italy who've moved up into third and sharing that third spot with Japan. Great Britain have dropped down into sixth.
If you think there's only just over a mark between Great Britain, 1.5 between Great Britain and second place, it's easily doable. Certainly going to vault, because in qualification the British guys didn't have such a good time on vault, and we've got some big vaults, so there is an opportunity there.
Yeah, Courtney has got a real chance to boost Great Britain's score, as has Jake Jarman, and we've got Harry as well.
Yeah, vault will be a good piece for Great Britain. I'm feeling confident they'll get three good vaults in. Pressure's on, they're good under pressure. And it'll just give them a bit of confidence for the last few pieces of apparatus. And Jake's up first. I'm impressed with Harry Hepworth. Apart from that little stumble on rings, that ring routine was some really classy work. And if you think at just 19, he's equaled the scores of Courtney and actually pushed Courtney out of the rings final.
This has been a high scoring piece as well, parallel bars. So the people that have already done vault and parallel bars have done two good high scoring pieces.
Well, Christine, I'm going to say it's a high-scoring piece of apparatus if you're from China. Well, I'm not saying the rest of the world is going to say it, because they are. It is a renowned piece of apparatus for China.
Well, they've given themselves quite a buffer. So they're actually four marks ahead of the rest of the world at the moment, are China. So they can afford a few mistakes.
Yeah.
But things will even out after Great Britain have been on vault, but USA have been on vault because they were in this. Great Britain are going to be going round with obviously Japan. So China, of the big hitters, are the only ones that have vaulted.
That's right.
Yeah, they've had a couple of good pieces. They all did triple twist on vault. They're all very good on parallel bars. They've got to get around the other apparatus. But I do think the medal table is wide open.
First chance to have a look at high bar. Christian Baumann of Switzerland. Traditionally classic piece for the Swiss.
Very nice stoop to handstand, and that was a good squat dislocation with half turn. You have to make your turns as close to handstand and catch your releases with your arms straight. Those are the prerequisites. You've got to do close bar work like that and pirouettes, as well as long swings. When you're swinging like that, it's a long swing. And when your body comes in close to the bar, it's a close bar element. You have to show both, and you have to show lots of different grips. And Christian Bowman certainly has shown all of that. Can he show his big dismount? Double twisting, double straight, he can. Well, he pretty much fulfilled the requirements of a good high bar routine there.
Yeah, one of the great European high bar workers, not giving too many tenths away for his team there and doing his very best to keep them up in that second place.
Great start for Switzerland. He had a nice variety in that routine for me. Plenty of height and flight on his release and catches, good in-ball work. Hit a lot of the handstands. He'll score well.
Yeah, 13-2-3-3 was what he scored in qualification, but across the vault, Dolce from Canada absolutely nailing that.
Great 2.5, slightly off to one side. But you're right, this has been a, we've watched this gymnast for a couple of years actually.
Yeah.
He's been up and coming, and yeah, he's certainly delivering. Look at that, in that, wraps in, 2.5. That'll just be a 0.1, but yeah, nice, been to the nines for execution.
Yeah, I remember tipping him from an all-around
medal.
Yeah,
I think you did. I said he wouldn't win a medal, but we'll see. Day after tomorrow, Matt.
He's a young lad, he's got plenty of time. So rings it is for the top group now. This, their third piece of apparatus. This is Paul Juda. He's 22 years old. One of the newer faces as far as international gymnastics is concerned for Team USA. But he is the execution king as far as the USA are concerned. Beautiful lines.
Strong first skill, back up rise to the top plunge. One of the requirements into the Maltese position. Layout into the handstand. That's nice swinging work. Double pike, double tuck, back up rise to straddle lever. Another top plunge. Good lift into the handstand, elbows off the cables. Can he execute a good dismount? Come on, you've got to fight. Locks out, kicks in, full twisting, double straight, spots the dismount.
Good. I mean, it's not the hardest rings routine in the world, but he executed it brilliantly.
Just that little bobble at the top. And, you know, I think they deduct a little bit for shape, body shape in that double straight with full twist. He was just a little bit piked, but very nice work.
Well, the USA dropped down into fifth. Christian Bowman scores a 13.866 for his high bar. China just coming off. Rotating round with Switzerland.
You're right, Matt. It's just lifting the Swiss team a bit. He's improved 6 tenths on his high bar.
So vault we go with Great Britain, and high hopes indeed for Jake Jarman. Very, very difficult. Look at this, a 6 difficulty. So the whole vault marked out of 16. Jake's going all out here for the team.
The most difficult vault we've seen so far. Oh! And a fantastic performance, 3.5 twist. He mucked it up in the first competition. Absolutely thrilled to nail that.
Well, what a performance on the world stage. When it mattered, he delivered.
Well, we needed that. Look at that. Wraps in, The 3.5 twist, 9.4 in execution, 15.4.
Jake Jarman, absolutely superb.
That's probably the highest score of the competition, I think, so far.
I think it is, the 13.6 for Paul Judah on the rings.
He'll take every tenth of that.
They're hard to come by, the scores on rings, aren't they?
They are. I thought they were quite low. If you think Jake's improved by 1.4 from the qualification.
Kaito Sugimoto now of Japan. He's next up on rings, 23 years old. Scored 13.766 in qualification. Such a strength-sapping piece of apparatus to meet you halfway around the six pieces. It's a long old way round.
Well, you find generally the all-rounders have to use a lot of the string swing elements to get their difficulty, but it's a good solid start. Crucifix into the Maltese, back up rise to the Maltese position. And the layout, that's nice, double tuck, double pike. Or that was a little high, supposed to swing to the inverted crucifix. He's got to hold on now. Lock those arms out, forward long swing. Oh, that little flex in the elbow is tiring. The lactic acid will be burning in his arms. Come on. Double twisting, double bite. What a landing. Yes, you needed that.
What a wind-up. And why it looked like he was on high bar. Absolutely superb.
It's hard to get 14s on rings if you think Courtney and Harry, with that level of strength, only got a 14-1. And for me, there was a bit in the middle where he swung to the inverted crucifix, which would have been heavily deductible. But that dismount, I mean, what a great way to finish.
You'll struggle to see a better rings dismount than that. I mean, it had the lot. And a beautifully nailed dismount to boot. So, Switzerland again. Serrani next to go. Here's their second up. Following Baumann, Switzerland in second place in this men's team final at the World Championships.
Good pirouette again. Stoop catcher, just a little bit loose in the knees. Winding up for the big release and re-catch, the full twisting. Back somersault over. And then another big catcher, two in a row, straddle pike. Lots of energy, hasn't lost swing at all. Just a little bit late on that full turn. Super high, Markeloff works out into the long swing. Hop full, hop 1.5, it's packed this routine. Here comes the dismount, full twisting, double straight. Just a half pace on landing, but they really are lifting their game, the Swiss gymnasts.
What a performance from these lads. Really, it's three up and three to count, and every single one of them are making it count.
Well, I'm looking at the list of the last World Championships, and they weren't even in the top 12, and now they're sitting in second position. Yeah. I mean, fabulous.
Yeah. Harry Hepworth next to go on vault. Another gymnast from Great Britain that's made the vault final. 5-6 difficulty. Come on, Harry.
Well, he's such a dynamic performer. Oh, look at that! Wraps in!
He made it look easy!
Oh, my God, that was absolutely phenomenal. 2.5 twist in the straight position. That was just superb vaulting.
Great Britain are on their way back.
He's such a no-nonsense gymnast, isn't he? Just gets on with it, plenty of power. Drive, look up into the air, straight front somersault with 2.5 twists and dead down the center. Lovely, big execution.
14.866. What a World Championship debut for Harry Hepworth. Sugimoto scores a 13.7 for his rings routine.
It is hard to get up to the 14s on rings, but he was a bit high, I think. and a couple of those skills.
Yul Muldaur of USA now.
See the effort. The ring's vibrating a little bit with the strength. There we go again. But he holds very good shapes, this gymnast. Very stylish. Needs to really be a little more fixed in his shapes some of the time. But that's good. Building up to that crucifix. Here comes at the swinging section. Into the two front somersaults. Oh, immediately into the crucifix again. He's certainly building the difficulty here now. Here it comes. Up and double double. And again, a dismount that really swung almost like into a high bar.
Yeah. Well, Yul was fourth place back in 2021 at the World All Round.
I had a 14 in qualification, but I can't see a 14 from this. Just, it was a little bit shaky at the start, loose in the arms. I mean, that was a good position, but he was a bit high going into it. We'll see, time will tell.
Back to the leaders now. Su Wei De, China.
Got just hovering under the bar. Full turn from the squat, dislocate. Half turn. Oh, lovely catch, Ev, in the straight position, full turn. Interesting wide arms.
Oh, no.
Well.
Well, there's one of the four marks they had as a lead gone, plus the value of the move.
Yeah, because to get the accreditation, they have to show a momentarily hang, and certainly wasn't that. I mean, the gymnasts have to really catch at full stretch, so they get the least amount of deduction, but it's a very fine line, Chris, isn't it, between full stretch and off the bar?
It is. You just have to have enough stretch to get the dowel of the handguard over, and you could say, I don't think he will be credited with that, you're right.
No. He's got a release and catch. But again, oh.
Oh, no.
And again, Kovacs with the full turn. Well, he was a bit further on, but not much more. He got his nose slightly on, and then he was quite lucky. Mm. I don't know who moved more than Matt, him off the bar, or you in that commentator's chair.
Yeah, me.
I think we might need a paramedic in the studio for Matt.
Well, it's a very good job that China had amassed a bit of a lead, because this is going to be, yes, a very costly routine.
Two marks, and again, he'll be down on his difficulty. In-bar work, a lovely Steinemann swing. Oh, and again, he's really shaking, this gymnast. I hope he's okay. Yeah, come on, finish safely. Wraps in, double twisting, double back. Yeah, two of those four marks at least will have gone there.
Oh, dear me. Well, let's just hope he's all right. That's the main thing.
And actually, his swinging work on the high bar was beautiful. Mm. But you have to re-catch it.
That's true, Chris. You have to re-catch it.
Mario Macciati of Italy. Italy were in joint third with Japan, coming up to bars.
Well, this is efficient work. He doesn't quite have the extension through the legs and the feet of some of the gymnasts we've seen, but he's certainly fulfilled all he needs to do. Very nice straight arm front somersault. Efficient work, this. Just stalling a little bit short of the handstand. You need to swing straight to the handstand, really. But that was a very nice Diamandov turn. And a good half turn. He's very strong in his back. He's holding his lines. Super landing from the double front.
Super work from Italy as Lucas Dauser of Germany runs up to chalk up the bars.
Well, he'll be keen to get on because this is a piece he was very, very good at in qualification.
Muldaur, 13.866. 8.066 on execution. He was a bit raggy. USA have just gone off the boil a little bit here. Asha Hong will be the last gymnast from Team USA to go on rings. And then we'll be able to get an idea of where they stand halfway around this competition. He's qualified eighth for the all-round final. There's Asha Hong. So then, the gymnast who was second at the US Championships on this piece earlier this year. Asha Hong, with it all to do for Team USA to try and get them on the podium.
He's a higher scorer in qualification for USA on this piece of apparatus. Swing to the inverted crucifix again, the shoulder's just a little bit high. We'll try and get flat with the rings, but that's good swinging work. Into the top plunge. Maltese position. Again, it didn't just fix and hold. Got to be flat with the rings for at least 2 seconds. Now that's better. Lay out to the handstand. You see that right arm, just a little bit of a flex. His arms will be burning though. So he needs a big dismount. Oh, it was a huge dismount. Double twisting, double straight. That was a great position, that.
Yes. Never was there a cry of let's go more needed than right now. You've got 3 pieces of apparatus left, lads, to try and get yourselves up onto the podium for the first time in about 10 years.
But that was a fab dismount, wasn't it? Double straight, lovely shape, double twist.
On to vault for Canada, William Imar.
Five, two in difficulty. Oh, but a big step on that landing. When you step right off the top mat like that, there's quite a bit of a deduction.
Such a shame, actually, because it was a good vault. Plenty of length, good block from the top. You'll be able to see here, just you've got to really work to keep your shoulders in line. Let's have a little look there. So actually, it started off okay there, Chris. Oh, and then his shoulders were down. Big step. He did well to keep the other foot in. 14.033. Only lost a 0.1. That was a good fight.
It was indeed. If you let both feet go out of the zone, then it's a bigger deduction.
It's been an interesting round, this one, Chris. It's not gone all to where. There's been plenty of mistakes from all teams.
There have, and as Matt said earlier, really, when you're talking about 18 routines, it's pretty unrealistic to think teams are going to go round without any mistakes at all. Matteo Levantesi for Italy.
That little bit of a step, so that's a couple of tens. Very flighty in the long swing. He'll travel back down the bars. Now, long swing, Diamond. Oh, what a shame. He just didn't get on top of the bar, and if you don't get your wrist on top and lock out.
You could see, actually, couldn't you, that his body weight wasn't over.
Look, up there, round. Look at his left hand. It wasn't fully round.
Yeah.
So then he tried. I mean, gymnasts do this in training all the time. They get out of things. He was very lucky to come out of there without injuring himself. So that's a fall on the apparatus. That's you've lost the skill as well. That's how you should do it. and he'll get the combination into the Bavzar. That's a lovely skill, actually, when he puts it together. Oh, and again, it's a little bit short on the swing. Suarez from the upper arm. It's a very difficult routine. I just think the Italian team don't look as polished as they did at the European Championships, Chris.
I would agree with you, but that he's got some very original, lovely work in there, hasn't he?
He has.
Real shame, that. But I would agree, they don't look quite so powerful as they did earlier in the year.
And they've got Bartolini back in the squad as well, which, again, he was a, you know, almost like the star of the show, and they performed really well without him. And I thought, yeah, they would have probably shown us a bit more in these championships.
Yeah, because there's plenty of work in that routine.
13.766, Cerani of Switzerland on the high ball.
Not a great rotation for China. I mean, they had a four-mark buffer after a phenomenal vaulting session, but, yeah, there's certainly a few cracks showing.
Yeah, I mean, it just shows that three-up, three-to-count format. It's tough. Once you get that one mistake, it's having that composure and that strength to be able to get back up, forget about that fall and continue with that routine. Unfortunately, he had the second fall. Obviously, waiting to see the final standing.
Well, that is all we've got time for here on BBC Two. But if you would like to stay with us, you can flip over to BBC Three for continued live coverage. And just a reminder to BBC Two viewers, we'll see you tomorrow, 7 p.m. with a women's team final. Bye-bye. Well, hello and welcome to continued coverage of the World Gymnastics Championships from Antwerp, where the men are kind of midway through the third rotation. We haven't found out the standings at the moment, but we can tell you that China were having a storming competition with four marks clear after they competed on the high-scoring vault. Great Britain have used vault to get back into it with Jake Jarman and Harry Hepworth. So things are going well from Great Britain's perspective, Gianni.
Yeah, vault's a massive piece for Great Britain. They've gone out there, they've delivered three vaults. And again, China have made a mistake. It's three up, three to count. Anything can happen. So GB have got to use this now to their advantage to take that to the parallel bars. And hopefully they can deliver some more brilliant scores.
Yeah, we thought we'd see great things from Team USA. They've sort of gone off the boil a little bit. They qualified second and you know, we had high hopes with a lot of new gymnasts coming in, Beth. But one team that's really surprised us is Switzerland, who are going round with China, and they seem to be getting a real lift from the Chinese team.
Yeah, the routines that we've seen, they've been consistent, they've been solid performances, but we do know that they've had good performances on P-bars and high bar historically. They've had medalists on those apparatus, so it'll be interesting as they head through onto the kind of floor and pommel whether they can keep that going.
I was just checking actually through the history books, and the last time that Switzerland got a team medal was back in 1954. So I'm going to keep everything crossed that they've got great guns. Really superb stuff. So Great Britain started on pommel horse, bit of a shaky start with James Hall. But as you know from last year, Gianni, when you were on that team, you know, you had shaky moments, and six pieces is a long way around and a lot of routines that you've got to go through. So you've just got to try and chip away all the time, yeah?
Yeah, it's the long game. You know, three up, three to count. Anything can happen. Like last year, we was in eighth place after three apparators, yet we managed to pull it back. We pulled it together and we ended up getting the bronze medal. So anything can happen. This is gymnastics.
Well, I can tell you, actually, we've just heard that if we just come towards the end, we're going to get as live with you as quickly as possible. But Great Britain have now moved up into second place. So really looking forward to getting on. We've got the fourth piece of apparatus left to go. But there you can see China in the lead ahead of Great Britain. Switzerland are still hanging on in there. They're in third at the moment. Japan have dropped down into fourth. So yeah, Japan were highest qualifiers. United States were second and Great Britain qualified in third. So things are looking very, very different to how they were in qualification. But we kind of expected that, Beth, because this can go anywhere, this team final.
It can. And your remark on obviously USA and Japan being further down, but they are now going to vault, which we know is one of the bigger scoring pieces. So I think once this rotation's round, we'll have a bit of a clearer picture of where the teams are actually standing.
Yeah. Also, we're Great Britain now moving to P-bars, and Max Whitlock, who is back and competing on pommel horse and high bar. But how do you rate him as a P-bar worker?
He does the job. You know, in qualifications, I believe he got a 14.1, and that's what we need. We need a routine that's secure and can score a solid 14.
Yeah. Well, the Chinese team, who we're leading, are on floor. This is Sun Wei.
And a very pretty first tumble, 2.5 twist. He's one of the classiest gymnasts you'll see, Sun Wei. Done some great forward tumbling. Here comes his back tumbling, double twisting, double back. Little bit low on that landing. Judges like to see the chest up on the landing. Like on that double twist. Two and a half, front full. Now all of these tumbles and the elements on the floor have a value. They take the 10 elements and add them together to get that D score, the difficulty score. You can also get bonuses for linking moves. So the tumble we just saw of two big tumbles, get some bonuses. This is a very important landing here. Big triple twist. The most popular move by far to finish a floor routine with. But that was a good, solid routine.
Great finish. Leave that lasting impression with the judges. Very light on his feet in his tumbling. You know, we talk about spatial awareness. It's a 2.5 twist. Textbook full turnout, arms down by the side. Knowing exactly where he was. Koi Young from USA on to the vault.
First of the USA vaulters, 5-6 in difficulty. Ooh, 2.5 twist. Very good, but he hopped just a little bit out of the white lines. But a very difficult vault. Handspring straight front with 2.5 twist.
Big vaulting. He is a very powerful gymnast. If you look at the amount of power he can generate into the vault there, wraps up, 2.5 twist, straight down the middle. Just that little adjustment, he'll take a 0.1 and a hop to the side. Score well though.
14.666, he's in the vault final as well as Koi. You're on the telly. ...14.033 for Sun Wei on floor. So can this Swiss team stay up on the medal podium and get a medal for the first time since 1954?
Ooh, gosh, that is a long time ago.
Next up for Swiss,
Lovely, 2.5 twist straight front. Great control, double twisting, double back. Really just have to control the adrenaline on this piece of apparatus. The sprung floor on top of the podium can often cause a few problems for the gymnast. You've got to really absorb it, stick the landing. Showing his ability at splits. Fix the handstand for the 2 seconds. That's his non-acrobatic gymnastic element. All well controlled. Linking those twisting skills together. It's a little bit soft in the legs, but it's going well so far. Stands up for the triple twist. Great routine. The Swiss are on it, Matt.
They're on it. Yeah, Florian, he was in the all-round final, the Europeans, earlier this year, impressed us there with his floor work, and he put in a 14-2 in qualification. Well, Max is back. Did a super job for Great Britain on Pommel Horse. And he's a good parallel bar worker as well.
Very smooth up into his handstand shapes. Great height on that front somersault. Good positive work. That's a very strong handstand shape, which is an absolute requirement. You can see good straight line through his shoulders. Lovely control. Oh, super high double pike dismount. That was a great routine from Max.
He's a class act, is Max Whitlock. And don't forget, he took an all-round medal back in 2014 at the World Championships.
He did.
Hasn't lost it.
Well, that was superb work. 13.8, Max Whitlock on the parallel bars, keeps Great Britain well in contention.
Every tenth needed. Big stuff from Great Britain. Florian Naganaga scores a 13.766, so down on his floor qualification score. In Chaopan, next to go for China. He's come in as a replacement for one of the Chinese team members, flown in from competing at the Asian Games.
Oh, a lot of pressure. Oh, what a big opening tumble! Double twist into a double front. Double pipe front. Looked like his chest was down a little bit. Sometimes hard to see with some of the camera angles. 2.5 twist. See a bit of a forward tumbler. Have to go backwards. Easily round there. Double twist. Certainly got a bit of pace about the routine. That was nice control. Ocean Wendy swing, a circle on the floor. It's a hold, required time, no problem. Final tumble. Oh, just that little adjustment. Good, solid routine for the lad that's just got off the aeroplane. Well done.
Well, floor was one of the pieces where China had an absolute nightmare in qualification. As a country, they finished 15th. Sumakaya on vault for Japan now. 26 years old, watch him go.
rockets off the top, the triple twist. Huge vault. Look how far away from the platform he is. And they are really pumped up now. This is a battle.
He's such a character within that Japanese team.
And you know what? I don't know whether it's just my observations, guys, but over the last couple of years, we've really seen the Chinese and Japanese gymnast personalities come out.
A lot
more whooping and cheering and, you know, you never saw that in the past. They normally be quite
very reserved, yeah.
It's great to see.
Well, Great Britain's James Hall is next to swing the parallel bars. He qualified in fifth place for the all-round competition, so James has been busy at these championships already.
Well, he'll want to put in a good performance after the fall from the pommel horse, and he can go over 14 on this piece of apparatus. Oh, that's lovely work. Lots of difficulty. Yes, well done. That's a very difficult skill, turning from one bar and then back out the other. The blind catch with the hand. Well done. Just a little flick with the legs. Come on, James, dismount. Oh, no, it's a straddle front. I thought he was going for a big dismount.
No, he's packing in the difficulty. He's getting
love
those tenths.
Every tenth counts. And again, lovely control of Stutz. Now this will be the dismount. Double front somersault. Well, yes, the Iceman is back.
What a fantastic landing. A wonderful way to finish this fourth piece of apparatus for Great Britain.
Oh, well done, James. Great to see him really fighting and nailing that routine.
Yeah, there's still two pieces left to go for these teams. In Chalpan scores a 13-8 for Floor, so not without deduction. Shimoto next to go on vault. Lot of pressure, just one vault. It's over so, so quickly.
Another powerful approach. Super triple and an even longer vault. These are massive, these vaulters. And when you think they're putting three twists into that flight, that second flight.
Yeah,
amazing.
It just proves the amount of power they can generate towards the platform, because generally you want the gymnast to block up into the air to get the triple twist in. I mean, look at that, 14.9, 9.3 on execution. That's why he's the world and Olympic champion. That might have just vaulted Japan back into the medals.
Well, Great Britain were in second, going into the fourth rotation. Japan were in fourth. And USA, fifth. Asha Hong, next to vault for them. He's going for a very difficult vault.
Now this is a six. Whoa, look at that! Full twisting, double back.
How did he get that last tuck round? He looked like he didn't have a lot of room and he just whipped it over.
Full twist. And that's off really 2.5 somersaults. Pretty spectacular, this, Christine.
Yeah, so it's a turn on the Sukahara with the full twist, but he does it throughout the whole vault, doesn't he? Half in the first somersault and half in the second. Really amazing vaulting. Look at that score.
15-1 deserves every 10. He's getting fiery down there. Come on, lads. What a team final. James Hall, 14.466 for parallel bars. Great Britain in fourth. Su Weide didn't have a happy time on high bar.
but that makes amends. 2.5 immediate punch front to nail that landing. He's got great height on his tumbles. Double, double, and he kicked that out to meet the floor. Little bit low with that landing, but a great twisting combination. Fab style. Another very elegant gymnast. Makes it all look easy. Full twist front into double twist front. Here comes this last tumble. Huge tumble. Just that little pace on landing, but that was a good routine, I felt.
Yes, Chris, plenty of height on some of those tumbles. One of them, the chest was down a little bit, but absolutely super efficient in the air. And you can see full twist. Wraps in into the double twist. And spot on there.
Great Britain's Jake Jarman, last to go on parallel bars. Three up, three to count. And Jake has qualified in fourth place for the all-around competition.
Well, we need a mid 14. Good control. Near the coach, settle down, locks out well in the handstand, that under somersault. Oh, he did well there with the half turn. Travels along the bar, and pirouette back down, watch the change in the body shape. Lovely height there, the Bavs are. Come on, we need this, just fix, squeeze the back, keep the concentration. This is good, come on. There's the studs, one to go, big dismount. Come on. Yes, just what we need. Well done, Jake.
Superb and fantastic camaraderie as well from the British team, from the sidelines. And I tell you, Jake really seems to thrive in this team. He's a fantastic individual. But put him in that team mix, Chris, and he relishes it, doesn't he?
He loves it. He rises to it, doesn't he? He likes that extra little pressure and team feeling.
Kazuki Nami.
Well, his floor was outstanding. What will we see on the vault? Well, that's what we saw, the triple twist. Not only high, long, but perfectly landed.
I mean, that was perfection. Absolutely beautiful. So competing alongside Great Britain, Canada, Felix Stolce.
The transition around the one arm, a Healy turn. And again, just a little bit soft in the back. Imagine there's a ruler between the hands and the feet. He's very solid on this piece of apparatus, and he has matured into a great all-round gymnast. Good tempo. He understands the working of the bar as well. Dismount to go, the double front with the half turn. Good solid routine.
21 years old, with a lot of difficulty in his locker. And doing a great team job here for Canada, who've climbed the world rankings recently. 14-1 for Dolce, moves them up into fifth. Sun Wei De scores 14-1. Roy Seifert. Last of the Swiss gymnasts to take to floor.
Such a popular first tumble and so difficult. Forward combination, finishing with a double front. Or just slightly overcooked, the double pike front. Very nice in the combination. So again, all forward tumbling. A lot of these gymnasts favoring a lot of forward tumbling. That was a good backward somersault with double twist. Wide-armed handstand into the lift into handstand. Also very popular combination. Just one big step on landing, all the rest have been great. And another very controlled landing there. For me, some of the tumbles were a little bit lower than some of the others, and the judges do deduct for lack of height on tumbles, as well as for things like legs bent and apart.
Well, you can really notice the difference of the quality of some of the gymnastics. You go from, you know, the heights that we've seen from some of the gymnasts from China, float across the floor, and you can spot the difference in height, Christine, there, and that's what the judges will be looking at. Should get a bit of confirmation of the standings.
Jake Jarman, 14.166, so a very good piece of apparatus for Great Britain. They were in second, and I think that will keep them there. 15 score from Japan. They've gone into the lead.
And the judges took 6/10 off that vault. Quite hard to understand where.
Paul Tudor. For Team USA, a 5-6 difficulty.
So it's another big vault, 5-6, 15.6. So it might be a triple twist. Oh, it's not. Double pike Yurchenko. That's the same tariff as the triple twist we've seen. He just landed with his hips back. It's going to be a difficult one to land that.
A big old Christian Thomas vault.
Actually, Christian Thomas could show him how to do the vault.
He could, yeah.
You see, this was just a little bit long for me. I don't know what you think, Chris, and that's why he landed with his hips slightly back. Just lacked a bit of pop off the top.
Yeah, he had to hold on to this pike for a bit of a long time, didn't he? Well, when you're still piked landing, it's tricky.
Awarded a 14-4. Seifert scores a 13.6 for Switzerland. They drop out of the top few and down into sixth. I think all of the judges have done their calculations. If that is the case, then Japan lead Great Britain in second. China, we believe, have dropped to third. With the United States in fourth and Canada fifth.
Top three teams look very tight, though, Matt.
Confirmation, yeah. Japan just 0.1 ahead of Great Britain, with China again 0.134 behind Japan. The United States drop out of the top three. Switzerland low and Canada have moved up into fifth. Things are getting very, very tight indeed, with two pieces of apparatus to go. And we can expect Japan to score very highly on high bar. They've got the difficulty, but you've got to stay on in order to achieve it, Chris.
Absolutely. So, Japan have got... P-bars and high bar left, haven't they?
Yeah, and they were top on parallel bars.
Yeah, I was going to say that's a big
But China
piece
have just put in some cracking parallel bar work, so they'll have to be on top form.
Yeah, China moved to pommel horse, which was another of their nemesis pieces in qualification.
And then I think, do they not finish rings with rings, which actually was their best? They were top on that.
Yeah.
It's the only piece they did well in qualification.
Yes. So Great Britain will have parallel bar, high bar and floor.
Good strong piece of apparatus for USA as well, parallel bars.
Mm.
They were fourth. They did a 44.4 pretty much, and GB did a 40.5, so they gained nearly four marks from qualification on Great Britain. But then when you go to the last piece, they scored a 38 and we scored a 42. We get the four marks back, but as we can see from the competition, it hasn't just played out as it did in qualification.
One thing we know is that Great Britain need to stay on the high bar.
Yes.
That's a given. That's a given.
And then we move to floor and we're all good. This is me hoping for a medal. Great Britain's last medal was a bronze at the World Championships last year, which got us the qualification for the Olympic Games. And before that, it was a silver back in 2015.
Well, if you think at the last World Championships, you were in eighth place at one time, didn't we? And we clawed our way back. And I think if one thing this should teach any gymnasts that are watching this, you should never give up.
Never.
You know, we've all had competitions where we've gone out and we've fallen on the first piece of apparatus. But one thing that the British team proved time and time again is if you pull together, you get your head down, you hit the routines, anything's possible.
Absolutely.
Maybe a gold.
Well,
it's anything is possible at this stage of events, isn't it? Point one off the lead.
Yeah.
Max Whitlock, you can see there, doing his bit again. He's working three of the six pieces of apparatus. Had 18 months off. Well, he's had a long enough break. Come on.
He's been on holiday for 18 months.
So... the fifth of six pieces of apparatus in this men's team final. Great Britain's Max Whitlock working three of the six pieces. What a team performance and a team effort from this man.
Great start. It was actually the highest scoring qualification for the British guys. And I think Max will be quite open to say in the all-round it wasn't one of his strongest pieces of apparatus, but he's learned to devise a routine that gives him maximum score, and he just executes the skill so well. He's only done one release and catch, and that's all that's required, and he's gained his difficulty from everything else. Watch into the dismount. Double back.
First class, Max. Absolutely superb. What a job. Pommel horse, tick. P-bars, tick. High bar, tick. Well
medal,
done, that
tick.
Man. Yes.
Absolutely fantastic. He was so efficient. What a great person to have in your team. Great person to lead the team. Show the others how it's done.
Absolute respect.
14.133 in qualification. Anything around that would be great. Pressure's on these guys though, Japan, to stay at the top. But knowing you've got your best two pieces of apparatus to go, they should be confident.
The only trouble with finishing with high bar is it's so low scoring.
Oh, Kazuma Kaya. Looking to keep his team on top of the world here.
Well, he needs to control all this adrenaline and fire and put it into the routine. Here he goes, front somersault. Fixes the shape. Very strong, very controlled. full turn, the Diamandov turn. Keeping his hand still, any little shuffles or deductions. Very good shape. Super straight arms on the swing. Here comes the somersaults. Beautifully, cleanly out of it into the pirouette. Super lift. Very swingy. Just a little bit bent knees on that straddle position. Here it comes into the big dismount, double front half turn. Fabulous landing. Not much wrong with that.
Phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal.
Absolutely. Into the rafters. You can see why they're the best in the world on this piece of apparatus.
Yeah, the only thing, Craig, I thought was that he wasn't terribly high above the bar in his straddle positions.
13.4 for Great Britain's Max Whitlock. That's a huge score. He scored 12.733 in qualification, so he's gone way above that.
He just really has been the star of the team yet again.
Yu Hao for China on pommel horse.
Well, this is a tricky piece of apparatus at the best of times, let alone when you're under pressure. And it started well. Just a little bit short on that handstand there. And again, just a little bit short. You've got to really look out to get into that vertical position. It's got plenty of difficulty on the apparatus, forward travel. Maggie Eye's got quite big shoulders, so it's quite difficult. Oh, and a good full pirouette dismount. One through, that's what they need.
He'll be over the moon that he's through there.
Yeah, clean finish.
That's a bit short on a couple of the handstands, though, Chris, in the middle.
Yeah, I agree. I think he was just happy to finish.
Absolutely.
Kazuma Kaya, 14.733. It's a huge parallel bar score. That's the first one up for Japan. Two to go for them. Fred Richard. He's next to go on parallel bars. Year-old scored a 14.6 in qualification, so he can swing the bars, that's for sure.
Impressive handstand start. Oh, wow, that was good. Kicked right out of that somersault. And a second on the straddle one. Oh, he's got real energy on this apparatus, isn't he? He looks like he's swinging on the high bar here. Clean pirouettes. No hesitation up into that straddle handstand. Oh, just a couple of little hand movements there and lots of tension. Oh, hop on the dismount. It was a good routine, but there were a couple of deductions towards the end.
Push through, and he'll be relishing every single moment of this World Championship debut experience for him.
Well, I think I have to agree with you, Chris. He started off fantastic. I mean, this guy's got real energy about his performance, but just tired a little bit towards the end on the last couple of skills.
Not surprised, it was packed with difficulty,
it was.
It? 13.4 for Yu Hao, which is not bad at all, actually. But James Hall, absolute stalwart of the British team.
He's just put together a solid parallel bars. It's routine, he's packed with difficulty though. Look, he winds up. Kovacs in, full to his position. Whoa! And again in the tuck, that's great catching. Full extension. Change the tempo. Oh, my word. I'm just going to say, change the tempo of the string for the catch, Evan. That's a relatively easy skill compared to the two big ones he's done.
Oh, what a shame for James. He'll finish it off, though.
Full mark down. In bar with the Stalder. Squat dissipate with a full turn. And the half, that's better towards the handstand. Hop full, dismount to go, needs a good solid dismount, trying to claw back the tents, winds up, kicks in, double twisting, double back. Well, what a shame, James. He'll be bitterly disappointed, I know, because he's such a perfectionist. He puts so much pressure on himself. Mm. What a shame. And like I said, he did the most difficult part of the routine.
That's often what happens, isn't it? You concentrate for those very super difficult skills, and then the easier one catches you out.
Fred Richard of Team USA, still in the 14s after his few wobbles. Daiki Hashimoto next up on parallel bars for Japan. Things going very, very well for the Japanese team. Two pieces to go for them. Just outside the medals at the World Championships on this piece a couple of years ago. He's capable of high 14s as well.
Yeah, he's got lovely swing. Generates lots of energy while he's swinging like that and then kills it right at the top. So able to work out of those difficult somersault elements. Very smooth. Parallel bars has changed dramatically over the last few years. It's a very swingy piece now. Oh, that was very nice. Lovely straight legs. Very smooth. Every turn's been bang into handstand. Here it comes. Oh, what height on that dismount. He lifted off the bars. He finished that dismount before he was back level with the bar.
Gosh, I mean, it's pure entertainment, isn't it, from a spectator's point of view, this, to see these, like, they just make it look so easy.
Well, I think, actually, that the skill there we saw was his worst skill in the routine. It didn't have some of the height over the top of the bars, and actually, in slow motion, he clipped the bars a little bit. But his dismount, one of the highest double front half turns we've seen.
A 12.433 for James Hall. Such a shame. Just have to wait and see. It may still be in with a chance of a medal. So we're next to go for China.
Well, China's just seen Japan banging out some good parallel bar work, so pressure's on these guys. And he started very confidently. That good extension on the double leg circle. And again, the intricate work on the one pommel. Wu travel. And again, this is really good work from this Chinese gymnast. Forward travel, good alignment with the hands. Backwards Javardo, just needs a good dismount. Oh, that's a good routine. Great work.
Our Sun Wei was in the Pomelos final at the Olympics. And they needed him there.
I like his swing, one of the best on pommel horse. I don't know if you two would agree.
I agree, he's got great extension at the front. And he's got a nice tempo about it, so he can keep the momentum going. And again, it's about the faster you go, the longer you can go for. It stops the lactic acid building up in the arms, cramping up. Great work.
Hashimoto, 14.866. He's upped his score from qualification. He was a little off in the all-round, the qualification, but he's getting refocused. He's getting back on track. A 14.266. for Sunway.
That's a big improvement, Matt. He only had a 12.966.
Yeah.
So he obviously fell off in qualification.
Well, Jake Jarman now with it all to do here. Just needs to stay calm. Easier said than done. The 21-year-old took a silver at the British Championships on high bar. And he's done his bit for the team as well today. Jake Jarman, floor to go after high bar for him.
Big swing here. Here it comes. Straight catch, Ev. And another, the straddle. Really swinging well out of these elements. Lovely technique. You have to show these different grips. There's lovely endo circle as his close bar element. Squat dislow with half turn, tiny bit off the handstand. But great swinging. Here comes the dismount. Two twists, just a little pace backwards. But there was a lot of pressure on his shoulders there. That was a very good routine.
Huge difficulty, and Jake Jarman comes through again for Great Britain.
Well, we need a 13. I think that'll be good enough. Let's just hope it's good enough to stay up in the medals.
Kaito Sugimoto looking to extend Japan's lead. They're stretching away from the rest of the world now. Sugimoto, the last of three, 23 years old, and he in qualification scored over 15. So watch this.
Solid start. Front up rise into the studs. Control locking out in the handstand. Lovely height there, the straddle front somersault, pirouette, travel back down the bars. That's the height on the Bavzar skill I was on about. Into a chance to clear the body. To pelt back into the bars, straight up to the handstand. A little bit of a pause there, but nothing too disastrous. Focus. Good dismount, the double front with a half turn. Well, I don't know if these gymnasts from Japan, they've got glue on the socks, because they nearly these dismounts, Matt.
Phenomenal, phenomenal. I mean, the level of difficulty that they're putting out here.
That was the best one of those I've seen today, yeah.
And I think you can see the difference between that skill performed by him and Hashimoto.
A very, very important pommel horse routine, this, for China. Lin Chaopan hasn't been in Antwerp very long at all. Flown in for this competition. Oh, he looks good.
He looks confident. Every Chinese gymnast always has great style. It's whether they've got the stamina and grit to get through the routine. This is lovely. Oh, and he has. He certainly is delighted to have come to Antwerp and done so well.
Well, great set of pommel horse routines from China there. Well needed.
13-2, yeah.
Down a bit on difficulty, 4.8. It felt a bit short.
Well, sometimes, I mean, this is the guy they've flown in. And obviously be a little bit tired.
Jake scores a 13-2. It needed to be in the 13s. One more piece to go after this for Great Britain. And it's floor, and he will be key, Jake. Kato Sugimoto scores a 14-8-3-3. Another huge score for Japan. High bar left for them. Yul Muldaur.
This is you. Let's go, baby.
Well, he started so well with Team USA. He's faltered a little bit through this competition. This gymnast very sharp on this piece of apparatus. That's lovely work on the long swing. And again, difficult connecting two big skills. We did well to retrieve that. A little bit flat. Lovely. In the front uprise, Suarez. And again from the long swing. Packed with difficulty and originality, this routine. Here we go, big dismount, double front with the half turn. That was fantastic. Well done, young man.
Well, that is exactly what Team USA needed from the US parallel bar champion. He's qualified for the parallel bars final. No surprise, I am sure. But this could be very close to 15.
What do you think, Chris?
Yeah, I like that routine a lot. And they've certainly had plenty of fighting spirit, the American boys.
Well, they're a mark and a bit outside the medals at the moment. It's very close at the top. There's going to be a fight on for bronze.
Certainly is.
Italy in seventh, but this will be a joy to watch. Bottolini was world champion on floor back in 2021. 27 years old now. Here he goes.
This is a hugely artistic floor. Even a double pike front half out looks elegant. Double twisting, double back, little hop on that landing. Oh, that was fabulous. Second somersault higher than the first. The ultimate gymnast for style, an extension. Lovely jump for good measure into the corner. Just floats the straight somersault. One big landing to go. The triple twist, just a little pace, but beautiful floor work.
Bartolini scores a 14.033 for his team. The last of the Italians on floor. Yul Muldaur, oh, he was close to 15, not quite, 14.933 for the US parallel bar champion. But what will that do for his team? Well, there are the standings with one piece left to go. Japan are in the lead by 2.5 marks, and the United States have moved up into second. China now third, and Great Britain behind China by 2 marks in that third place. Floor to go for them. Very, very, very close. Who knows? Time will tell. Canada in eighth.
I'm going to say, Matt, I'm going back to qualification. GB had a 42.8 on floor. and USA had a 38. So there's four marks difference, but they need to hit the floors. And obviously, USA could probably do better on the high bar. So,
it's going to be close.
It is. We've got two powerhouses, Harry and Jake. And James again has the opportunity.
It's going to be the US because China, they won on rings, so they've got a lot of marks.
Yeah. Yeah, they're going to their best piece now, China, aren't they?
Yeah.
So I'm sure they're going to stay up there.
Battle for bronze.
And actually, through all the ups and downs, this is often the story in men's gymnastics. Japan and China in a battle for bronze.
Yeah, I mean, it's a tough piece to finish on. The USA counted two falls in qualification on high bar, and both of the lads that fell, they're putting up in the team final. Mm. So it's all or nothing.
Yeah.
But that is what a team final is, really, all or nothing, isn't it?
Yeah.
You can't go for being safe, steady Eddie.
No, and interesting enough that China scored 43-6 on rings, and Japan scored 43-6 on high bar.
Oh,
so
really?
As it stands, Japan would stay in the lead, but they've got to stay on, and we've seen a few casualties on the high bar. Yeah.
And it's three up and three to count. So
place your bets.
Oh, hey, we love a last piece, don't we?
Do you know I think I have my bet on China?
Do you?
Yeah, I think I do.
No chance. Yeah, but
they're four marks adrift, you're right.
Yeah. Well, I'll take that bet. We heard it here. Christine said, sorry, Colin, she's bet a lot of money. The house keys have gone on the table. Thank you very much. Well, I'll put my money on Japan keeping the first spot.
Well, the last time they won gold was back in 2015. Koh Young sets things off for USA.
With a very nice Markelov. Oh, he finishes that full turn right in handstand. Here we go, straight Kachev. Straddle, a bit flat those, but secure. Good Stolder. Strong dismount, first man up, answers the test.
He's through. Wow, what a performance from the debutant. Huge pressure.
I was going to say, he's a little bit flat on some of those releases. Not the biggest start value. Had a 4-5 in qualification. But he's through, so the pressure's on.
Liu Yang for China. For a medal for them, the first of three.
He's a top qualifier on this.
He is a 15-2.
Here we go.
Well, just look at the physique. That's the physique you want to be if you're going to be great on rings. And how about that for an opening element? Shoulders right down and a second one, swing to it. He makes that look easy. And I think that is easy for him. He looks like he could stay there all day. Such fantastic strength elements, and of course it's these elements linked together that gives him the big difficulty score. The swinging elements straight to the top planche and then into the crucifix. There's no shaking of the rings here. Swing to handstand. Double-double, just a pace. That was the only little mistake on that routine.
Wow, phenomenal from the current Olympic champion. He was world champion almost 10 years ago back in 2014.
And what really impresses me about this gymnast is, if you look at some of the frames of the great ring workers, yes, he's got a decent set of shoulders on him, but he's not as big as some of the other guys, but the perfection on the skills.
12.833 is the markup on where he was in qualification. Kasuma Kaya. Looking to help land his country on a team medal, a gold. First time since 2015 have been victorious in the men's team final. It feels like this is their year. Three routines stand between them and gold.
This routine's packed with difficulty. He winds up to his first big release. Full twisting Kovacs in the tuck position. Much better on the straight, Katchev. Just floats above the bar. Straddle Katchev. Oh, that's nice work. Squat this great full turn. Again, the half turn into the handstand. That's what the judges are looking for. Lovely original in bar, Steinemann work. Dismount to go. Kicks up, double twisting, double back. Nails the land here.
Absolutely phenomenal. Phenomenal. Two more routines to go for Japan.
I'm not sure if it's a shouting competition on high bar between America
Let
and
cheer.
Japan.
Listen, I'm sure we'd be doing the same thing if we'd just done that, Craig. What?
Well, he played safe on that first release, didn't he? He caught on quite bent arms, but then he let it fly on the catch-ups.
Lu Yang, 15 scored, 0.2 down on his qualification, but that's very, very useful indeed for keeping China in contention for a medal. Sun Wei. You've got the difficulty, you've got the strength. This is one of the safest of the pieces. What a team job this lad's done. He's worked all apparatus.
And he's still firing on all cylinders here. Brings that beautiful style to the rings. Shoulders not quite level with the hands. Those are all the little places the judges deduct. But that was very nicely done. Oh, he's got to press into that pure handstand. He gets it there. And again, you can see a little bit of movement on the rings. Two steps on the double-double, but he's done his job. Six pieces today, and he can give himself a big smile at the end of that.
Yeah, some nice swinging work there. Not score as high as the first gymnast there. You're right, Christine, he was a bit high, and then he lowered down into that level crucifix position. Looked a bit tired towards the end.
Kasuma Kaya, 14 scored for high bar. Paul Judah now, he's the American high bar champion. Beating the likes of Brody Malone. He doesn't have the hardest high bar routine in the world, but again, execution is key with this gymnast. Real flair.
I would say this is something for America if they could hang on to a bronze medal. Lovely height there. Tuck Kovacs, two somersaults over the bar. Straight Katchev. And catching on full stretch, linking two together. Squat dislocate there, looking out into the handstand. Lovely position, the handstand there. This is good work from this gymnast. Full twist in, double straight. Well, wouldn't this be something if America hang on to the third spot?
Such fresh faces as well. The new blood is here. And my word, what a performance they're putting in.
He's got lovely style, hasn't he? The full twist on that dismount was just classic.
He's done as well, it's job done. One more to go for them. 13.966 for Sunway on rings. So, Great Britain's Harry Hepworth. He's in the floor final. He scored 14.5 in qualification. Just outside the medals at the Europeans earlier this year. Just 19 years old. Vastly gaining international experience. And what can he do here in this men's world final? The team competition.
Oh! Just a little pace outside, but beautiful height on that first tumble. Oh, and he landed right outside in the sit down. That's one whole mark off. Very costly. That's more like it. Double twist into double front. To deal with this sort of pressure before. That was better, two and a half, straight front. Full twisting, double twisting, double back there. Oh, and a step out on the final triple twist. Well, it's a cauldron down there. And he'll be mightily disappointed with himself.
But it's got unbelievable skill level for 19 years old. And the thing is, he's going to be back.
This gymnast has got huge potential. And you can't put into words the pressure that these guys are under. They're fighting routine for routine. They're slogging it out against the best in the world. And, you know, he'll take that performance, work with it, and then come out fighting for the floor final. But these guys here, USA, Japan, have gone head to head.
Paul Tudor scores 13.933. Fred Richard will be the last to go for them. But first, we're heading over to rings. Yuhao will be next. Qualified in eighth, going for a medal here in this men's team final. The current world team champions, China, with Yu Hao as their last gymnast to go. He's qualified for the rings final. He was second place back in 2015 on this piece of apparatus, took a silver in the Olympics.
And phenomenally strong on this piece of apparatus, lowering directly under the rings and pressing back above. Not a flicker on the Maltese crucifix. Double layout between the rings, circle round. What's the strength here? Straight into the crucifix. Not a problem. Double front somersault, and again lowers into that position with just sheer perfection. Dismount to go. winds up. Double twisting, double straight. Oh. It's a good routine, but I think they'll have to set up a silver today.
Well, it was huge. Yu Hao was only doing rings, and what a performance. He had a long wait. Last piece of apparatus to go, and, well, he nailed it.
Well, he certainly made it his own. Fabulous body shaping throughout that routine. Well, they're really trading blow for blow here, aren't they?
Frederick Richard for Team USA. And a team medal for the first time since 2014. Huge pressure.
Oh, beautiful catch. And another one, such difficult skills. Now, make the easy ones as well. Lovely catch, Ev. He's got great extension on this apparatus. Lovely lift at the back of the releases. Great one-arm circle. Here's the forward elements. Swinging really... Oh, and he just plummeted a bit. He got out of it well. He's super strong. But it will be a bit of a deduction. Here comes the dismount. Lovely, super landing. Wow. That should be enough for a medal.
What a recovery. And what a performance from Team USA. They think it's good enough. We think it's good enough. But we'll have to wait for confirmation from the judges. But what a finish.
Well, they've threatened for many a year and always failed at the final furlong. But today, they were fantastic and a very well-deserved medal. I think that'll be the bronze.
Yu Hao scores 14-8, 6-6. It says first at the moment, but all calculations are not in yet.
They're the first team to have had all three performers finish.
Well, Great Britain's Jake Jarman will be last to go on floor, a Commonwealth champion. Few tenths off what he would have wanted in qualification. He's reserve for the floor final. He scored a 14-3-6-6. He's more than capable on this piece.
Well, he played safe on the opening tumble and only adds an extra half twist. Triple twisting, double back. And so easy. He just skips into the tumbles. Look at that power. Double twisting, double back from almost a couple of steps. Absolute huge talent. Triple twist. Just down the side. Rush and Wendy circle. Just has a quick look where the corner is. Full twist into the 2.5. And again, full into the double twist. I mean, it can twist for fun. Final tumble. Stands up for the 3.5. Great way to finish, Jake. It's not been the competition the team have wanted. I don't think they're good enough to get a medal today. But a huge learning experience for these guys.
Do you know, they've kept battling though, haven't they? They've kept pushing all the way around.
They have indeed, and that was a great floor routine from Jake, finishing with 3.5, really one of the top.
Oh, it's 14-5-3-3 for Frederick Richard. That's a big high bar score. They don't want to celebrate too early. for Daiki Hashimoto. King of the all-round will wrap up Japan's team competition. He's last to go.
Unbelievable pressure on his shoulders. He didn't have a great qualification. Desperately want to bring it home for the team. That was very nice. Squat Dislo with half turn. Well caught on the release and catch. Here's another one, full twist in the tuck position. Change of tempo, there's the Kachev. The downswing means a change of action at the top. There was the straddle Kachev. Oh, that was extremely late. We meant to try and catch those near handstand, but he got away with it. Very nice body shape through his swinging. Come on, feet into the landing. They are. That should be enough for his team. They believe it.
Oh, what a class act. He is Hashimoto. He's sure he's done enough. It looked like a golden performance. Their team has looked golden all the way around, but they've been pushed.
They
by
have.
This young team from the USA.
And eventually by China as well.
Well, if you think in the World Championships last year, Japan qualified in first place and got toppled by China in the final. But this year, qualified in top spot, kept the top spot. Great work. Great, great work. And a fantastic result from China to pull themselves back up. I did say there's no way they're going to finish down in eighth, but what's been remarkable, I think, is the American team. They really have lived up to the hype.
Amazing.
For once.
What a team final this has been. It's had the lot. It's been packed with difficulty. Harry Hepworth scores a 12.8. And landing outside of the area.
It'll be interesting to see where the British lads finish.
We've still got a couple of scores to come in.
14.533 for Jake Jarman. Big floor score.
So that puts them in third, but we still got this.
We still haven't had Jake yet.
Yeah, still got this final score to come in.
Hashimoto's score to come in, so Great Britain will be pushed down into fourth. The worst place to finish. There's confirmation with a score of 14.366 for Daiki Hashimoto that they are the new team world champions. They take gold for the first time since 2015. China will take silver and the United States of America take the bronze. What a team final.
Well, what a surprise for the British lads to claw themselves so close back to the podium, Christine. But you can see the look of disappointment on Max's face. But to be fair, he's come out and performed faultless, Chris.
Oh, he has. And there were just a few unfortunate errors. I mean, Harry's very inexperienced. I mean, even really, like doing a team qualification and then 2 days later doing a team final, that's something that you have to learn how to cope with. That's not what you do in domestic competitions.
No.
So he's inexperienced, and then we've had others with just unexpected errors, really. But as we said, for all teams, you know, 6 pieces of apparatus, 3 people on each, 18 routines, you're bound to have some mishaps.
Yeah, and I'm going to put a positive on this, Chris, because actually sometimes a result like this can be a blessing in disguise. We're less than a year from the Olympic Games. If you cast your mind back to 2012, we struggled to qualify a team in London, and we ended up with a team bronze medal. And I think the worst thing that can happen in, whether it's sport or organisation, is complacency to creep in. And I think it'll just be the motivation that the British men will need to go, actually, we won't just be able to rock up to the Olympic Games and pick up a team medal. And we have still got some gymnasts at home, which are out, you know, through injury. Joe Fraser is a great all-rounder. He's been missed from the team. You've got Gianni. We've got great depth. And I think the selectors will have a real tough job picking the team that goes out to represent Great Britain in Paris next year.
Oh, absolutely. We've got a great deal of depth. We've got lots of different variations of people that can be used. But there we go, look. Paris 2024, they're on their way. That was what everybody mostly came here wanting to achieve, qualification for Paris. But great scenes from Japan, and they've worked as a cohesive team so well here.
Well, if you look at the list down there, Switzerland are in fifth place. They weren't even in the top 12 in Liverpool last year at the last World Championships. So great work from the Swiss guys.
Great work from USA as well.
Yeah.
And again, another really quite young team here. They'll be building for Paris. But you know, they won't quite have the same gay abandon when they get to Paris. There'll be expectation on their shoulders. There's nothing quite so like the first time a team of young gymnasts make the grade.
Yeah, well, I guess they came into the World Championships with nothing to lose. But yeah, what a great competition. And the new World Team Champions, Team Japan.
So Japan are victorious. China finished second after qualifying eighth. And the United States of America there with that bronze medal. It's been a long time coming, and Great Britain there finish, I'm going to say, uncharacteristically in fourth place. But Gianni, what was that like for you to watch it? Because, I mean, you're going to be, hopefully, fingers crossed, out there competing against this lot here.
Yeah, it's tough. You know, Harry, this is his first World Championships, so I think he's already gone out and made three finals, and he just has to use this now as experience. Mm. You know, it's always tough seeing starting pommels, it's a shaky piece. James made a mistake.
Yeah, yeah.
Then high bar again, it's one of those apparatus where it's hit or miss. And at that level, you're going for broke. You're going all out.
Yeah,
and
obviously
today that cost the team.
And actually all you can do as a team member is just keep chipping away and keep putting it out there. And it must be hard within the team when things start, you know, going a little bit haywire to kind of just keep buoyant and keeping that frame of mind that you need to be in to be doing this level of difficulty in execution.
Yeah, three up, three to count, you know, you're counting every score. So when you start to make a mistake, when one mistake happens, you try and let it go.
Yeah.
And then another one, you know, unfortunately happens. This is the sport. It gets to you. You try not to think about it, but in the back of your mind, you're thinking, you know, we really needed that. But again, anything can happen. We've seen that the teams were just bouncing around between second, third, fourth.
How aware of that are you when you're on the competition floor?
I think you're always paying a little bit of attention to it. I mean, some of the boys don't. Me personally, I like to just keep an eye out now and then just to know where we're at and what we need to hit.
Yeah.
So, everyone's different.
There was a lot of fire down there as well today, wasn't there? I mean, you could obviously, if you were down there, you'd be able to hear the Chinese and the Japanese like roaring at times, Beth. I mean, they were really, you know, there was a lot of emotion.
Yeah, there was a lot of animation from the gymnasts, and it just shows how much it means to them. But also there's that level of respect. Even when the last gymnast was getting down the American guy.
Oh, yes, Fred.
And he was in the middle of the Japanese celebrating with them before he went to the rest of his team. And it just shows that level of respect within the rest of the gymnasts to say, do you know what, yeah, you've done your bit.
Yeah, what do you make of the new arrivals from the Team USA?
Yeah, it's not... I mean, the Americans are always there or thereabouts, yeah. And we've always kind of tipped them to take the medals, and they've always, unfortunately, had mistakes at the wrong time. But even today, there was small errors there, but not enough to take them away from that podium place today. And I think some of them, you can feel that they're from that college gymnastics environment. They're very fired up and they're constantly supporting each other.
Yeah, well, fourth, I'm sure you'll agree, Gianni, is the hardest place to finish. Betty Glover is in Antwerp right now and she's with the British team. I'm sure you'll be very interested, Gianni, to hear what the lads have to say. So, Betty, it's over to you.
USA, also USA.
Thank you, Matt. Yeah, I'm with the lads now. Max, fourth. Is that the hardest position to finish?
Of course, it's difficult in many ways, but I think there's so many positives that we can look at. I think going out there, doing what we've done, I think everyone's done a great job. There's definitely stuff that we can work on for next time, but these are all learning curves as we kind of lead in and get closer to Paris. But I think overall, I think we need to be positive. We've done well to go out, guys. We've come together and we've done our jobs.
James, there's three generations of gymnasts in this team. How proud are you of everyone here?
Yeah, it's incredible. Like you say, you've got an eclectic mix here. And, this champs, maybe it wasn't what we wanted it to be today, but we had new routines. We had, people going for sticks, for perfect landings, for perfect execution. And sometimes you can't quite pull it off, but I'm super proud. Great guys as well. Great gymnasts, but even better people.
Jake, there are lots of positives to take from that. In particular, your vault. Where on earth did that massive score come from?
Yeah, I mean, I was just going for broke, to be honest. For me, doing that vault, it was quite a sigh of relief because I kind of messed it up in qualifiers, but to be able to do it today, I felt like I proved to myself that I could do it. But I also really just, I wanted to do it for the team, and to see that that score come through for the team just, it made me so excited.
Yeah, you look buzzing. Courtney, what sort of learnings can the team take from this then, less than 12 months out from the Olympics?
We just need to stick together and keep pushing, keep working hard, keep pushing each other and keep believing in ourselves. This is a very strong team here and we can do even better, and we will do.
Harry, this was your debut on the world stage. How did you find it out there? And also, how did you find the pressure? Because this is the first time that you've had to sort of perform under that sort of pressure.
Yeah, once again, it's a feeling you literally can't describe, and I was so glad to experience it with these bunch of boys. They're amazing people.
Did you enjoy it?
Of course I did.
Of course you did. Luke, you were watching as a reserve. What did you make of it?
Yeah, it's amazing to be part of this team and watching the boys today. I'm really proud of us all. Yeah, there was a few mistakes, but I'm really proud of everyone.
And we're just going to come back to you, Max, because this was your first time back on the world stage after 18 months out. You did three apparatus. It was like you'd never left.
Thank you. No, I appreciate that. It feels good to be back. It feels good to be back with the team. There's still a lot more jobs to do. So look, we'll take this on the chin. I think it's a positive that we can come fourth in the world and be a little bit gutted with it. So there's huge projects to take. We'll move forward. There's more finals for the whole team, so we'll see where we can go from here.
And just finally, your little girl Willow was out there. She was calling for you. Did you catch her eye? Did you see her?
Yeah, I did. As soon as we walked in, and I'm sorry, I had to run up to this interview because I literally wanted to go and say a quick hello to her at the end. But yeah, amazing. I've always said I wanted to have children as I was a gymnast. So I wanted Willow to be able to watch me in person, not just on videos. And it's amazing that she got this experience to come to this one.
What did she say to you?
She couldn't hear me, to be honest, so I need to try and catch up with her properly after this. I was trying to shout over the banister, but it is what it is. But I think we'll have time after this. Time to recoup, time to go back, rest up for the rest of the finals.
Do you know what? We'll let you get back to her and let you guys get back to whatever you need to do. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, no doubt it was daddy, I love you, I love you. We all love you, Max. Honestly, welcome back. And absolutely superb, as he said there, three pieces of the six, and he delivered. I mean, I said it in commentary. Pommels tick, P-bars tick, high bar tick. We're going to have a look at his pommel horse routine first off. I felt nervous for him stepping up there, but he's just such a class act, Gianni.
Yeah, and, although this is the team final and that score is needed to count, I think he would have been using this as an opportunity to prepare for that pommel final as well.
Yes.
It's another opportunity to get the routine done under pressure. So,
yeah. What does it feel like, Beth, when you've got all that weight of expectation on your shoulders? I mean, you had like the whole of Britain on your shoulders when you stepped up there.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting because when you're a specialist, you're coming in and you're expected to perform on that moment. And for Max, obviously, for so long, it was about the all-around, about the pommels. Then he took it down a level to being a specialist on pommels and floor. And then, obviously, now he's kind of using the pommel as his specialism, but knows that he needs the other key pieces of apparatus. But also, that helps him individually. If you're going straight into a world scenario and you've only got one piece, that is so much pressure. Whereas actually having those two other pieces, you can sometimes use that to your advantage. You get out into the arena, you can feel the environment, get yourself into kind of the competition. And I was chatting with Gianni. I mean, I think Craig mentioned it in commentaries. High bar wasn't necessarily one of his favoured pieces during the all around, but he now has routines that he's happy with. He's consistent.
Kind of working
with
the code.
And he can
respect.
Just do it.
Yeah. 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 Yeah, I mean, did you? I guess you and all the team were kind of wondering what Max was going to do when he came back. Because if he was just a pommel specialist, it wouldn't have worked out, would it? So he's had to really concentrate on not just coming back for pommels, but actually upping his game with P bars and high bars so that he can go out there and be a real talisman.
Yeah, you know, the team dynamic now is very hard to make it with one apparatus. Mm. And for Max to be able to come into that team, he needs to offer a little bit more. And he does. He's covered on P-bars, he's covered on high bar, and they're secure routines, which the team needs. So he's done a fantastic job. And like I say, pommels is his apparatus where he can come in and deliver a good score. But also for him to come in and deliver good scores on P-bars and high bar as well, you know, is incredible because the team really needs that.
Yeah, and it's interesting when you look at the eclectic mix of gymnasts that we've got across the board and where we do really well and where we can work a little bit more. I say we, the royal we, you guys, can gain those extra tenths. I mean, you look at Jake Jarman. I mean, you know, Betty said it. Where did that score come from? Just when it was needed, he lines it up and it's absolutely superb. So let's have a look at Jake Jarman's vault here. I mean, he's in the... He's in the vault final, and this is why.
Yeah, so this, we spoke about this vault a huge amount last year because he kind of put it out on the scene then. But the level of difficulty of that vault, most gymnasts can't even entertain having a go at into a pitted environment, let alone in a world championship final. To put it into context, Jake had problems with this vault in the qualification, but because of the difficulty, because of the execution he does use, he still made it into the final with those problems.
Mm. I mean, and it's a risky move, isn't it, to do vaults? Because they're over so quickly in a team final like that, and it's three up and three to count. So, you know, just deciding what level of difficulty to go for is a whole other factor within the team final.
Yeah, and I know the coaches would have said to Jake beforehand, you know, we need this vault. We know you can do it. He's probably landed it 100 times in training, and it would have been a good opportunity again to get a practice before that vault final. So although, you know, he was practicing for that vault final, again, the team needs that big score if we want a chance of a medal. So.
Absolutely. And another gymnast that went all out in exactly that department was Harry Hepworth on floor. Sometimes it comes off and sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes you just want an extra 20 centimetres of floor area. Here's a perfect example.
Yeah, you know, Harry's new to the world scene. I think this will be a massive learning curve for him.
Yeah.
And he does have a floor final coming up Saturday, which, again, gives him another opportunity to try and just learn from today, hopefully.
Yeah.
And, you know, hopefully on Saturday he can deliver a solid performance like he did in qualifications.
On that note, quickly, how does it feel to be giving up that world floor title?
I'm sad, you know, come Saturday, that's it. I don't have an opportunity, unfortunately, this time round to try and retain the title. But fingers crossed it can come back to the UK, and I'll be wishing all the best to Harry in that floor final.
Yeah, yeah. You'll be back out there before too long, Gianni. Honestly, you will, you will. But, I mean, it was a phenomenal performance from Japan, Beth. I mean, they were a joy to watch all the way around. We said there was a lot of emotion out there. They didn't hold back. We're going to have a little look at Hashimoto's... oh, no, sorry, my mistake. Minami's vault first of all, following on from Jake Jarman. I mean, look, I mean, the level of vaulting that we're seeing is just phenomenal.
It's not even just the difficulty. The difficulty's there, but it's the execution that is coming with these vaults now. You used to see some of these difficult vaults, but you'd see several steps or you'd see them coming out of bounds. But when you're getting vaults like that, three twists, three and a half twists, and they're staying bang in line, they're textbook.
Yeah, all extra tenths for height and length and just, I mean, absolutely magnificent. And all the way around, they were just pushing it, getting further and further ahead of the rest of the world until Hashimoto took it home and won the first medal for them, the gold medal since 2015. And Gianni, it wasn't a given of how far ahead they were going to be, so there was a bit of pressure on this, and he's come off before as Hashimoto.
Yeah, it's still a very, very hard routine to do. You know, he still needed to go, you know, stay on, deliver that routine, and he's got multiple releases. But he just looked solid from start to finish. There was a slight mistake in the middle. He did a squat four that was slightly late, but really, you know, he covered it up quite well. And he's just solid, absolutely solid. And every time you watch him on the high bar, you just get excited. Incredible gymnast to bring it home.
Oh, yeah. Everyone was with him. It was just a superb all-round team performance, one after another, three up, three to count. They made every single one of them count. And it makes you wonder what would have happened with China. They qualified down in eighth. They were pushing it right from the start. They were out there until they went to high bar, and poor Sue up there. I mean, he was shaking. We just hoped he was going to be all right, but he didn't have a happy time here, Gianni. What was going on with him, do you think? Because it was relatively not a difficult move, but he did real flair.
Yeah, and that's it. I think you're going for broke. You're trying to go for execution, and you know, everything just looks slightly off from the catches to, you know, those releases there. Everything was just slightly fingertips, and on a piece like high bar, you've got to put it on the bar.
When you're doing those huge release and catches, and you're somersault and you're twisting over the bar, at what point do you know that it's in your? Like, I know it sounds weird, obviously when you catch it, but just before you catch it, do you know you've got it?
I think sometimes you can feel it. So sometimes I feel myself on top of the bar, and I know I'm on. And there's times where you feel like you're slightly the wrong, like you're slightly late.
Yeah.
Because we train by like actions and timing, so you see beforehand they do the giants where they speed up, they kind of move the bar in different directions.
Yeah.
By that, you kind of know whether you're on or off the bar. And honestly, it really comes down to when you catch, you know when you're like, you just catch it.
And the bar's world champion's nodding next to you.
Yeah. And do you know what? There's times where you think you've totally got it, and the next thing you're pinging off, and yeah. So it's just
it's heart in your mouth stuff all the time. Now Liu Yang, we're going to have a look at Liu Yang's rings, because you know, just unbelievable. Olympic champion, former world champion, got the lot, and. It won them a silver medal in the end for China.
Absolutely incredible. I was watching this routine thinking, wow, how is this guy this strong? But it was an incredible performance and an incredible routine. And China are solid on rings, and what a piece to finish for them. Rings is one of those pieces where it's a lot less edgy than high bar or floor. So, you know, he did his job.
Well, it was phenomenal all the way around. Tomorrow, we're going to look forward to seeing the women's team final, which will be a very similar time. You can join us on BBC Two from 7 p.m. and then we'll do that little channel hop at 8 p.m. for all you gymnastic stalwarts there that want to join us on BBC Three. But huge thanks to Beth and Gianni for sitting through that one. What a final it was. That is the first of the 14 finals decided. It's job done for the men. Japan were victorious, and their team spirit was more than high. But hope you can join us tomorrow when the British women's team will be hoping that they'll be back on the podium. And my word, are they in good company. See you tomorrow.